This video was produced by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
The first confirmed case of mad cow disease in the U.S. in 6 years.
Two supermarket chains in South Korea have stopped selling U.S. beef.
So how did this cow get sick, and how dangerous is this development?
During the late 1980s and early 90s, an outbreak of a disease called BSE occurred in cattle across the United Kingdom. The press called it mad cow disease, and it was all over the news. BSE, which stands for Bovine Spongiform Encephalopathy, is a fatal degenerative disease that affects the central nervous system of cattle. The name comes from the sponge-like appearance of the brain tissue of infected cattle when viewed with a microscope. Scientists believe that the BSE agent, like the causative agent of other transmissible spongiform encephalopathy diseases, is an abnormal, misfolded form of the prion protein. This protein occurs normally in vertebrates and is found at highest levels in nerve tissue. For reasons still unknown, the BSE agent converts the normal prion proteins to the abnormal form in a slow, self-perpetuating process that leads to degeneration of nervous system tissue, the brain, and spinal cord. How is BSE transmitted to cattle? BSE is transmitted when tissues from infected cattle are rendered and processed into protein meal, which is then used as an additive in livestock feed. Before the BSE threat was recognized, BSE spread from cattle in England to cattle in other countries when those countries imported cattle infected with the disease or meat and bone meal derived from infected cattle. Can humans be infected with BSE? In the 1990s, investigators looking into the risk of BSE to humans found that cases of a human version of BSE called variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, or VCJD, were likely caused by eating beef products contaminated with central nervous system tissue, such as brain and spinal cord, from cattle infected with BSE. For this reason, the Food and Drug Administration, or the FDA, and the U.S. Department of Agriculture, or the USDA, require that the highest risk tissues of cattle, called specified risk material, or SRMs, be removed so they do not enter the human food supply. In the United Kingdom, where most of the VCJD cases occurred, the number of cases peaked in the year 2000 when 28 cases were identified. VCJD is very rare in the United States. Only 4 cases have been identified in people who likely became infected while living or traveling outside of the United States. VCJD is not contagious. How is the spread of BSE being prevented? Science tells us that BSE is transmitted through feed, so the best way to prevent the spread of the disease is to ensure that the feed manufacturing and livestock production industries follow regulations that the USDA and the FDA put in place to protect the U.S. food and feed supply. In the late 1980s, USDA put import restrictions in place to prevent live cattle and protein derived from cattle from coming into the U.S. from the United Kingdom. USDA also put a surveillance program in place to test high-risk cattle for BSE. In 1997, the FDA enacted its original BSE feed regulation, or feed ban. This rule prohibits feeding mammalian protein to ruminants, which are animals with a four-chambered stomach, like cattle, sheep, and goats. In addition, the rule requires facilities to label products that contain mammalian protein with the caution statement, "Do not feed to cattle or other ruminants." An additional enhanced BSE feed regulation was put in place in 2008. Where the focus of the 1997 rule is on keeping mammalian protein out of ruminant feed, the focus of the 2008 rule is to keep the highest risk cattle tissues out of all animal feed. In 2003, a cow imported from Canada to Washington State was found to have the classical form of BSE. In 2004, the U.S. increased its surveillance testing substantially. Under this enhanced BSE surveillance program, the USDA tested more than 780,000 cattle between 2004 and 2008, and then reduced the level of surveillance to approximately 40,000 animals per year. In addition to the imported cow in 2003, the USDA found one case in Texas in 2005, one in Alabama in 2006, and one in California in 2012. While the last three cows were native to the U.S., they all had what is called atypical BSE, that is, a strain that's different from the classical strain that caused the outbreak in the United Kingdom. In May 2015, member countries of the World Organization for Animal Health, or OIE, recommended that the OIE Code Commission recognize atypical BSE as a condition believed to occur spontaneously in all cattle populations at a very low rate, and to exclude cases of atypical BSE in determining a country's BSE status. The OIE considers the BSE risk in the United States to be negligible. Because of BSE control measures put in place around the world, the number of BSE cases worldwide has dropped from a high of about 35,000 cases per year in 1992 to just 13 cases in 2012. The U.S. was successful in limiting the introduction and spread of BSE in the United States because of early import restrictions and the enactment and effective enforcement of the 1997 and 2008 BSE feed regulations. It is vital that we remain vigilant about protecting our feed supply by enforcing the feed bans. Despite everyone's best intentions, mistakes do sometimes happen, particularly if equipment used to prepare or transport cattle feed is also used to prepare feed for other types of livestock, such as poultry or swine. So FDA's feed inspection program is essential to keeping everyone, inspectors, renderers, feed manufacturers, and livestock producers, focused on their role in keeping BSE out of the animal feed supply. Thank you.